The challenge of taking Lion King from screen to stage probably has three major elements. The first is that the film is pure cinema. It's a cinematic movie. It's staged with big, wide, huge shots. The second thing that's hard, of course, is it's a movie about talking animals. There's no people in it. And the third part is, to fill up a stage show, you need to be able to expand the story or to illuminate those characters. And 100% the solution for that was director, creator, designer, Julie Taymor.
What struck me so profoundly about the animated film was the humanity in the characters, the facial expressions of Scar, of the hyenas, of, you know, the humanness of those animals was so much the success of that animated film. So how do you keep that? In each character, I would find a different place for the human beings. And the first one that I did, I think, was the giraffe.
In anyone else's production, you would have hidden all the puppet parts. But Julie, by exposing all of that and lets you see the dancer, lets you see the puppeteer operating it, asks you to join in the whole style of the show.
I knew of Julie's magic, and I knew of her superb imagination, you know. And we all wanted to come up with a brand new looking Broadway show that the world had never seen before. And Julie was there with us 24/7. And if we had a problem, she came up with 10 ways to fix it.
I believe that audiences are capable of doing two things at once, which is to be looking at the stagecraft, the how it's done, as well as being lost in the story and the character. When you watch the mask of Mufasa or Scar come off, you are experiencing the theatricality, the act of creating the character, as well as experiencing the character. It is a double event theatrically because you literally have a mask of a character and the face of a character. So you are seeing the lion and the human at the same time, that duality.
Think about the character of Simba. Well, he appears in five different ways in the show. He appears as a small puppet. He appears as a rod puppet. He appears as a shadow puppet. And he appears as a child and an adult. So it takes two actors and three different puppet techniques to deliver Simba in The Lion King.
Another challenge faced by the show's creators was that a stage production would need a lot more music than the original film, requiring them to return to the root of the story and take a closer look at its setting.
In the movie, you know those five songs, but that wouldn't be enough to sustain the show. So diving into the music meant two things. One, going to Elton John and Tim Rice and asking for more music from them, but also we turned to Mark Mancina and Lebo M, who'd created a lot of the sound score and the beautiful African chanting that we hear in the movie, and to expand that into full-blown song material.
Since Lion King is set in Africa, that's the main musical influence, which is an African one. So you hear the percussion, which is the heartbeat of Africa, the rhythm is African, so there's a lot of other music in the show, but the main musical influence is an African one.
South African choruses, which are the backbone of the music in the Lion King movie, they're going to be on stage, so they are the character. The chorus became a much more powerful and important character.
With the visual concept behind the stage show in place, and the music developed and expanded to work in the theater, what other ingredients were needed to complete the Lion King's journey from screen to stage?
I think when people say they cry at the beginning and all that stuff about the Lion King, it's because it's so ancient, this technique of letting the audience participate and fill in the blanks. They don't need it to be real. They need it to be suggested. These are the original concepts that I had, which is to show the rods and strings, to not hide the operation, that there is beauty in watching people make it happen.
You know, when the audience looks on stage, they don't see a giant wooden staircase. They see Pride Rock. And they don't see people with grass pallets on their head. They see the savannah. Once the audience sees the magic of it, then we have them on the journey, and that is the best kind of thing.
Amazing Tangazile Sonny, and we are Disney's The Lion King. Over the next 30 minutes, we will be giving you just a small taste of what we do on stage 8 times a week in London at the Lyceum Theatre and across the UK on tour. Now, just now, you were listening to the fantastic Tangazile singing a stripped back version of A Circle of Life. Now, this huge number opens our show. As the sun rises and Rafiki calls out across the savannah, giraffes strut, gazelles leap, and birds swoop as they come together at Pride Rock to celebrate the birth of, you've guessed it, Simba. Now, one of those animals is a hornbill called Zazu, and he is the king's right-hand man and royal advisor. And this character is played by the fantastic Gary Jordan in London and Matthew Forbes on tour.
So, Gary, you play Zazu in the West End production of the show. You've played him for 3.5 years?
3.5 years now, yeah.
And how would you describe him then?
Oh, wow. yeah, he's fussy. He's fussy, isn't he? Well, he is the king's majordomo. He is Mufasa's right-hand man and advisor. I kind of like to think of him as a spy, really, because his main job is to fly around the Pride Lands and make sure that everything is in order, make sure that no animals are eating other animals that they shouldn't be. But obviously, as we know, unwittingly, he ends up being Simba's babysitter, which he really does not like.
He doesn't like at all, does he? I think sometimes...
He doesn't like that at all.
There's definitely bits to him that I sort of feel that he's really good at his job in some areas and then dreadful in others.
Absolutely. I think anything to do with affairs of state, he's very good at. Mm-hmm. But anything else that comes with the job... He's not so great. As we know, he loses Simba.
Yeah.
And they end up in the hyena's lair. And he has to run and get Mufasa because that's a part of the job, really. He's not that great at.
Yeah.
But
Well, he's just brilliant, isn't he? He's so funny. I think all of his one-liners are just perfect. And the interaction that you have with all of the different characters. I think he's one of the only characters that chats to pretty much everybody. Do you know? You chat to Scar, you're with Simba and Nala. Yeah, and I love all those gags that he's got, all of those little one-liners. I love the fact that I get to sing Let It Go on stage. That's hilarious.
I love the fact that he's just slightly shady every now and again with some of the words that he chooses.
Absolutely.
He's sort of, everybody kind of says mutters things under their breaths if they're not happy with the situation, but he doesn't mind just saying it. So I love that about him.
I mean, he looks brilliant. You know, the makeup is incredible. The makeup team are just absolutely brilliant. The fact that they're able to do all of that blending with the white and the blue, I could not do that.
What about the white and the blue? What does that represent?
Ah, good question. So I asked the original makeup designer when he came and when we were setting up the tour, and he was saying that it's all about the clouds. So obviously Zazu, being a bird, spends a lot of time in the air, and so the white fading through into the dark blue is supposed to be the sky and the clouds. And so you're supposed to sort of see that, as Julie Taymor says, with the double event. You see the puppet and then you see puppeteer being clouds and sky. So the puppet of Zazu is really, really complicated to operate, isn't it? I struggled during rehearsals. How did you get on?
Definitely struggled. I had six weeks rehearsal, and so much of that was trying to get as one with the puppet. You know, it's tricky to maneuver, and you want it to be as smooth and as kind of realistic looking as possible, I guess.
I don't know about you, but I sometimes, when I meet the audience after the show, sometimes they go, oh my gosh, it was amazing when the puppet did this, the puppet did that, and I didn't do any of those things, but their imagination has made them think that has happened, and that's great.
It's interesting though, because it is the most, I'd say it's probably the most traditional puppet in the show, because essentially it is a string puppet, really, isn't it? It's all controlled with strings. And
yeah, I think a lot of the other puppets have got that, they're sort of extensions of costume, aren't they? Like the giraffes, which are brilliant.
Yeah.
They're stilts and then sort of big hats. But then, but he's sort of a thing by himself, isn't he?
It's funny you should say that, actually, because somebody did come and stay with me for a few days. Would you like to say hello, Matt?
What have you got?
Oh, hello.
Hello, Zazu. How are you?
Very well, thank you.
Oh, look at him. Oh, look at him. Whoa. God, it's been ages. Oh, look.
So it's time for our first Sky VIP question. All of the lions wear masks above their heads. Is it difficult to dance and perform wearing this heavy headwear? No. It's not heavy at all, because the masks are actually made up of carbon fiber, which is the same material that they use to make race cars. So they're really lightweight. But sturdy at the same time. They paint them to look like wood, and they paint them to look like stone. But in reality, they're really, really lightweight.
What is my favorite thing about doing the show? I just love this show. I just love the storyline. The storyline is just amazing. It just brings so much healing to everyone who does it every day, and to those who come to see it every day. The storyline is a story of hope, finding yourself, and everything that has to do with positivity, you know, and the fact that in life we do face challenges, but in the end, if you don't give up, I'm in love with the storyline of The Lion King. It's just amazing.
We're looking back and counting down some of our favorite Lion King moments over the past few years. Kicking us off at number 5, it's the Disney in the West End Summer Pop-Up. Over the past 2 years, we have brought the magic of Disney on stage to you in a free, interactive, and up-close experience in the heart of Covent Garden. Now, unfortunately, we have not been able to bring the pop-up back this year, but we have everything crossed. We'll be back bigger and better than ever in summer 2021. Number four, it's Lioness versus Lioness. Now, dancers from The Lion King joined the England women's football team to prove that it takes a lot to be a lioness.
It takes a lot to be a lioness.
It takes a lot to be a lioness. It takes hard work.
It takes determination.
It takes years of training.
But I need to be right in this moment.
I need to work as a team.
But stay focused as an individual.
It's about passion.
It's about energy.
Dedication.
Fitness.
Skill.
Belief.
It takes a lot to be a lioness.
But it's worth every single second.
We'll look at more of our top moments later on. Up next, it's Janique Charles, who plays Nala in the London production, singing Shadowlands.
Time for another Sky VIP fan question. Who is your favourite character in Lion King and why? Aside from Zazu, I'm going to say Nala.
because she, the adult Nala, she is a very strong, confident woman. She stands up to the bullies of the piece and finally leaves her home, her family, her life to try and save them all, which eventually she finds something that does save them all. And I think Nala is really the hero of this piece.
What is the most rewarding part of being in The Lion King? Well, the most rewarding part of being in The Lion King for me is simply being able to share the stage with so many talented performers from all over the world. We've got artists from South Africa, China, Brazil, USA, United Kingdom, Trinidad and Tobago, where I'm from. And it just makes our environment really, really exciting to be a part of, because it's a huge melting pot of different cultures and languages and traditions, and it keeps you on your toes. But essentially, we are one big global family within one company. It's pretty cool.
Do you ever get the chance to play a different character or try on another costume? Yes, I do, actually. As well as playing the role of Zazu, I also understudy the role of Scar, which I have my own costume for, which brings about a completely different set of challenges. But it's always fun to bring out the bad kitty.
Collaboration with the London Gay Men's Chorus. In 2017, we partnered with this incredible group of singers to celebrate Pride in London. The video was a huge hit with the fans and has more than 10 million views since it was first released. Penultimate moment. Meet Brooke Morgan. She is one of the young people that Centrepoint have worked with to help secure a brighter future. Centrepoint are one of the leading charities in helping young people faced with homelessness. Brooke Morgan bravely spoke out at the Lyceum Theatre to explain to audiences how Centrepoint have helped her.
I'm Brooke Morgan, and I'm here today at Disney's The Lion King to tell over 2,000 audience members my story. Since 2018, The Lion King has partnered with Centrepoint, and I want to share some of the amazing things that this charity has helped me with in the past. Firstly, I'm meeting with the cast member Nick Afuar, who plays Simba in the show, just to get some tips on the speech I'll be doing on the Lyceum Theatre stage.
Thank you. I came to Centrepoint in 2015 after a bereavement I had in my family, and that literally shattered my mum and I's relationship. And one thing that you guys are supporting, which is just paramount to Centrepoint really, is things like education systems and services and so on and so forth, which has put me in an awesome place, and they gave me the space I needed to really grow independently and strongly. And as a result of that and them helping me, I've now founded my own community interest company called She Oath, which focuses on instilling authentic confidence into vulnerable young girls, girls that once looked like me once upon a time. So thank you so much for the help and support. Thank you. Nick. Having the opportunity to speak in front of an audience that large and share some of my story was absolutely phenomenal. In terms of the partnership between The Lion King and Centrepoint, I think it's amazing, and I think it should really continue for years to come to be able to really speak about a cause that is worthy of being spoken about.
Several years ago, a special version of Endless Night was recorded to mark Lion King's partnership with Centrepoint. Performing for you, this is Deshaun Young.
Where has the starlight gone? Dark is the day. How can I find my way? Home is an empty tree, lost to the night. Father, I feel so alone. You promised you'd be there whenever I needed you, whenever I call your name. You're not anywhere. I'm trying to hold on, just waiting to hear your voice. One word, just a word will do to end this nightmare.
Here comes another round of Sky VIP fan questions. How long does it take to get into makeup? Well, the character of Zazu has a very, very blue face, and it takes about 40 minutes to get full makeup look done. First of all, I will get into the chair at about 6:30 for a 7:30 show, and the makeup artist does a brilliant, brilliant job at blending what starts off as white right through to a dark blue. It goes down my neck, in my ears, right inside my ears, and I get a blue wig and a blue bowler hat to finish off the look. So it takes about 40 minutes in total, and looks incredible at the end.
The two main techniques that I use to bring out the animalistic side of the character of Mufasa. First of all, I remember that he is a king, a husband, a warrior, a father, and that he's extremely humble human being. But then on the other side, I have to remember and put to the forefront that under that very thin veil is a ferocious wild animal, which can be unleashed at any time. So I try to bring the two energies to the forefront on a knife's edge to bring across that powerful but unpredictable nature of that animal on stage. And the second technique that I use also is the Javanese and Balinese movements to emphasize the cat-like kind of gestures and head movements on stage, just to kind of emphasize the fact that he is a feline. So they're the two main techniques that I use, mental and physical, to kind of incorporate the character of Mufasa.
And finally, our top Lion King moment. In 2019, we marked the London production's 20th anniversary with a week of celebrations. Take a look at what happened.
Welcome to the 20th anniversary of The Lion King.
We gave an entire performance away to Londoners. We painted the town yellow and even took over Lion King's Cross for the week. We finished the celebrations with a very special gala performance in support of the Royal Academy of Music and Elton John's AIDS Foundation, a night we'll never forget. We'd just like to say thank you so much for spending the last half an hour with us. We cannot wait to be back on stage performing for you. And to sing us out, this is Can You Feel the Love Tonight?
Can you feel the love tonight? The peace the evening brings, the world flowers in perfect harmony with all its.